Around the World Media presents On the Move Unscripted. We're turning today's unknown talent into tomorrow's stars. For more details about the show, visit aroundtheworldmedia.com. Now get ready to be entertained. Here's Patricia Goins and her co-host MBJLive.
All right, we are back. So, you know how I have to always start this off. I don't know if you slid by 1100 a.m. on accident, or if it was on purpose, or if you loved last week's show, or the show before that, and you just said, you know what, I need to come back and hear what they're talking about this week. I don't know what your reason is, but whatever your reason is, you have tuned in to another edition of On the Move. Unscripted.
Yeah.
Tell them what unscripted means.
Unscripted means is never planned. It's really just freestyle off the top. And, you know, whatever our heart and mind take us to. You know what I mean?
Right. What's unscripted mean to you, Marvin?
Hey, anything goes.
Yeah. My unscripted meme means, you know what, don't be tripping when we make no mistakes.
Yeah.
So, how was y'all's week? How was your week, Marvin? How was your
Shout out to that pink dress, Patricia.
Huh? Am I flowing today? I'm flowing today. I'm feeling. You know what? As a woman, the beauty of being a woman to me is being able to switch up. You know what I'm saying? When I get married, my husband ain't going to never know what hit him. When I get married, my husband going to be like, who are you today, baby? I'm going to be like, Jacqueline.
Tina Turner.
You know what I'm saying? I might have an afro with big bow earrings. You know what I'm saying? Coming in with, you know, I ain't going to do stilettos. I ain't going to be able to do stilettos. You know. So anyway.
So how was your week, Patricia?
My week was awesome, but I'm gonna tell y'all this. I had a little emotional. I don't know if I want to call it emotional breakdown, but I really like. Y'all heard about what happened with the 4-year-old Malia Davis out of Houston,
yeah.
Texas. So, oh, and we got. I forgot. I forget about you, Al. And we got
Angel.
We got Angel and AJ in the house. What did I say? I say his name wrong?
Got two A's.
Got two A's in the building.
We winning.
I didn't say his name wrong. Did I say your name wrong?
Mm-mm.
Because Bigg Jigg will get me, and so will Marvin.
Yeah. Yeah, she's good for calling you Jiggity and Biggity and No Diggity.
But, yeah, I was really affected by that because I am a survivor of child abuse. And everybody knows, you know, I wrote the books or whatever about my experience with child abuse and how, I, you know, if it was not for my grandmother, I would have been killed. She would have killed me, like, hands down. So when I seen this story about Malia Davis and the fact that she's still missing, you know what I'm saying? And the fact that the father said, allegedly, and I have to say allegedly because, of course, I wasn't there and he hasn't been convicted or nothing like that, but allegedly, he says he was on his way to go get the mother from wherever she was. And on the way there, he had a flat tire. He stopped and all of a sudden come to these three Mexican men or Hispanic or something, and they knock him out. And they take the little girl. But the son was still in the car. I'm like, that right there does not sound right to me. And then as they continue to go through the investigation, still trying to look for this little girl, they're finding blood in his trunk. They're finding blood in the house. They're finding, you know what I'm saying? The last evidence of pictures that they have, because, you know, there's cameras everywhere now. So they
Then they said something about they found some thing of bleach or something here.
Yeah, and they seen him carrying
a clothes basket or something, yeah.
Yes.
With a garbage bag in it.
Yes. And so that, when I say that, brought me to tears because not only are they not able to find this baby, you know what I'm saying, or whatever. And the last time they seen a photo of, they were together. It was him and her. They seen her go in, never seen her come out. But I saw him come out with a basket, all that kind of stuff. But beyond that, Children's Services had just taken that baby from them the year before. So my thing is, why would y'all send them back? What did they really prove to show that they was able to get that baby back? You know what I'm saying? And that's what happened to me. Like, when I was abused, my stepmother broke my arm, and they ended up sending me to the children's service. Children's services took me out the home, and I was in foster care or whatever. But then after a period of time, they sent me back. And no, she didn't start back right away. But after a period of time, it was like, it went right back to, you know what I'm saying? The abuse started right back up. And I swear to goodness, if my father had not gotten up on Christmas Day and took me to my grandmother's house, she was going to kill me. Like, I'm talking about that kind of brutal type of abuse, like stabbing me in the foot with a knife and hit me in the back of the head with a crowbar and, you know, pouring boiling hot water on my arm and beating me with jumper cables until I couldn't walk. Like, she was crazy with it. Like, she would have killed me. And so when I seen that story, it hurt my heart. And it made me just feel like, why do they keep sending the kids back? We have, we got one caller on the line. Which one? Number one, Mario. Hello, Mario. Mario got tired of it. He didn't feel like hearing all that. So, we're going to go to Ronald. Hello, Ronald. Is there a Ronald? Ronald McDonald. Ronald McDonald. Okay, so.
R-O-N-A-L-D. Ronald.
What did I say?
No.
Okay. So, yeah. So, what are your thoughts about, what all did y'all hear about the story? You said something else happened in Texas.
Yeah, it was a young lady that the police was just messing with her. She was going back to her apartment and, first of all, he a man, so you ain't even supposed to touch a female being an officer if you are not a female unless a female there.
Right.
So he was out of pocket anyway. So he snatched her up, tried to cuff her. She was like, nah, let me go. He took her down to the ground. She was like, I'm pregnant. So she kept tussling. He tried to, like, bend her arm up, and she slid out. So when she slid out, she kind of kicked away a little bit. He bagged up and shot her, like, 3 times.
Oh, my God.
And killed her, you know what I'm saying?
Oh my gosh! Like,
it's out of pocket. Like, it's getting out of hand because it's like, you know, everybody, you know, of course, you know, God put laws in placement for a reason. So, you know what I'm saying, you got to kind of respect the law to a degree. But at the end of the day, it's like the police starting to become the new gangs. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, for real, they're starting to become the gang affiliation more than them serving justice. You know what I mean? Because they've been getting away with a lot. And it's like, it's unfair to civilians because at the end of the day, like, they treat it like, okay, well, we kill somebody, we going to jail for life or whatever, you know, mm-hmm. first degree murder. They kill somebody, all they got to do is say it was unfair for their life. Mm-hmm. And they off. You know what I'm saying? That ain't fair, man. You know what I'm saying?
And so now you done killed the woman and her child.
Yeah.
Because she was pregnant.
Yeah.
They said that she wasn't after the autopsy. But that's what she was saying at the time when he was actually accosting her.
Oh, so they said she,
she might have just been saying that to try to get him off, thinking that was going to work to get him off, but obviously he was enraged or, you know, he.
Well, you know, they'll say anything to make it seem like, you know, because that's double homicide.
Yeah, it is.
That's double homicide. You, they'll lie about anything. And truth be told, the laws never did apply to us anyway.
Nah, at all.
Starting off anyway, they never applied to us because we wasn't even considered a people. We was considered property.
Yeah.
So we was merchandise. So the laws that applied, it didn't even apply to us. So the stuff that they doing now, the Jim Crow laws, all that different stuff, and it never stopped. They just fashioned it differently.
I know that. And I don't know how many people realize this or whatever, but does everyone remember when they stopped busing in Clayton County?
Yeah.
You
remember? Everybody remember that?
Yeah.
So I was actually living in Clayton County during that time. And what tripped me out and what I still think about today is the time period that they did it. Like, when Obama started campaigning, what was that, 2008?
2008.
That's when they stopped it. Mm-hmm. When Trump got in office, that's when they started it back. So for 8 years, am I lying? For 8 years, there was no busing in the entire county. Now, I'm trying to understand, if you didn't have the money for busing in 2008 when Obama was there, how you find it all of a sudden when Trump got in office?
The economy grew.
That.
Well, you know, I don't know if people really recognize, but you know, a lot of areas like where I live out of Henry, They don't believe in they vote against the busing because they feel like everywhere that bus commute is crime. So they don't even like to have, that's why they don't like to have really buses in certain areas. Like, you can't catch buses in certain areas because of that.
I mean, and I understand that. And in all honesty and fairness for those particular, I can understand that because it probably does. If you can't catch the bus out there, you ain't gonna be able to do nothing, you know.
Right, yeah.
I understand that. But for that particular situation, I just feel like, was that just coincidental? Or was that was that a blatant Malcolm X, Martin Luther King type boycott type situation that happened right in our face and we didn't see it?
But I mean, you know, everything kind of blatant now. I mean, they put it in your face. Yeah. How they feel about us, you know what I'm saying?
It's more open now. They're way more hiding.
Nah, they ain't hiding.
A lot of killings that's going on that I think is uncalled for, unwarranted. Even with the lady, like, there's nothing that anybody can possibly do that can force a person to kill somebody in cold blood.
Yeah.
That was just, to watch that, you know, and for it to go viral, like, that's just, it's just out of control. And my whole thing is, you know, marching is just not going to get it.
What's up with Texas, too? It seems like a whole bunch of stuff be happening in Texas.
There's a lot of stuff going on in Texas.
Actually, yeah. You guys remember the young boy that Oscar Green, I think his name was, in Oakland? The lady got shot the same way he did, but the difference is he was in the subway tunnel, and they were at point-blank range the same way that she got killed. The same way that Oscar Grant got killed. And they made a movie about his life. Mm-hmm. Remember Fruitvale Station?
Oh, that. Yeah. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
And where was that at?
That was in Oakland, California. Okay. Up north, yeah, on the West Coast.
Same way.
Yeah, that was tragic.
He was right over top of her. Same way you talk about, oh, I meant to tase him.
Yeah.
So would you,
I remember that.
Say you meant to tase her, too?
I remember that.
I don't know if y'all ever seen this video, and I searched for it. I saw it on World Star Hip Hop. It was right around the time when Mike Brown got assassinated.
Yeah, Missouri.
Yeah, in Ferguson. And so I went back looking for this videotape. This white guy walked in the precinct. I don't know if y'all seen this or anybody. Somebody seen it out there. It was on World Star Hip Hop. This white dude. Walked in the precinct, about 6 to 9 police officers, everybody strapped. And the guy walked in, started arguing with the police officer, and he assaulted him and tried to take his gun.
Mm-mm.
They took him to the ground, pinned him down. So it was like 3 other officers just turned around and just looked and turned back around and finished their conversation.
Mm.
Oh, okay, yeah, there's somebody white. Now, if it had been somebody black,
they'd have killed him, probably.
They would have killed him. Everybody would have got a piece of him, like Rodney King, you know. Uh-huh. But soon after the Mike Brown, I searched that video. They must have removed it.
Mm. That's deep. Yeah. That's deep. So, okay.
You got a caller on the line.
Hello, caller.
Or to backstab you for stuff you believe in. Females out here is trying to make an impact. They could get actually killed for us standing up for their own woman. Some men, you're in a situation to help a woman, you'll have to leave the woman. Some of them are so pig-headed, like, you could say, miss, do not do that. By the time you look around, they'll break in your apartment, even though they have keys, mold environments, they will not clean them. And when you write a report, bye.
Sir, where are you calling from?
Texas.
Texas, okay. So you're calling in because you want to talk about the women,
experience.
What you experienced, domestic violence, what the men experience.
Men are getting worse. If you say the wrong word wrong, any Mexican, wow, look at your complexion to us. We come from the Caribbean trying to help. You got killed for your mouth.
Okay, so I'm confused, so I want to make sure I understand. Are you talking about domestic violence, or are you talking about the race issues in Texas?
Race issues. If you barely say anything to a Mexican, good morning, good afternoon, some of them will like you. By the time you turn your back, they come like backstabbers. Some of them love, some of them racial. You don't have to say nothing. You might meet a friend going through something the same way. It could be a Caucasian to a black or a Mexican care for you. I know you from my past. How you doing to heal you? But some of them, backstabbing, you pay your bills, they come knocking your door, they kicking your door, breaking your apartment when they have keys, leave you in a mold environment, and don't give a rat's butt about you.
So are you saying this because you feel like with the Malia Davis thing that it might have been some Mexicans that actually did that? Is that what you're saying?
I can't say, ma'am, because anybody could kill you, even to your own race. Because it's like you do the good, the watch you think you have it, bow, you die for those talking.
Are you speaking from your own experience? Have you had a bad experience with some of the situations you're talking about?
I've been here in 2000 or 2004. Mm-hmm. Come back here just 2000. What you could say? Close to 16 October. Why we can't get along with our own blacks? You know what it is? Instead, we embrace our culture from the Caribbean, migrating back here to help one another. No, they're looking at you, have all the money, you barely get anything. They're jerking teeth and stealing out of your apartments. You barely have anything to give them. It's F you, or MS word, or MF. When it's going to change, is tell all of us, stand up and say, hey, we got to hit with Trump at, or go someplace to Congress and say, how much domestic violence we got to put on our own women for stupidness they don't believe in. Get up, stand up for yourself. Some of them even damage their leg. They will not stand up. They will be quiet. How much wrong can you do blacks down here? We can't be suffering just like other people. Give all the Caucasians who have knowledge just like us. They'll turn against you. I learn a person say, the less you say is better for you. But even though you stand up or you don't want to say nothing, it's like you're gripping yourself with your own mouth. You open. Oh, no, don't say this. Don't say that. Some famous one trying to take the lead, but you don't know how, as an African-American migrating from the Caribbean, you mention a word N, what you're not supposed to say in the rap music. I could freestyle any song, anytime. If you want me fling a song to you, straightforward and blunt, that's what they're going with. Garbage, no knowledge. Wow. None about sex, violence. If you have to increase peace like Obama them, we never get ahead. If we got to go black and black, half of them are not educated. They don't think. They just respond to what? Sex, pornography, guns, drugs. When are you going to wake up in Texas, dude? We're going through, oh, you want to smoke marijuana? How much of them are dying from it? We got to smoke cigars. We're trying to relax good. You can't even enjoy a party. Your own race tearing up this stuff. You meet a couple of Mexicans on the same beat, they'll love you. But the rest, in the same boat, all who have the negative energy trying to let it out in a positive way, we're going to jail for standing up for blacks, whites, everybody.
Well, I can hear your, passion.
I'm on sense.
I can hear your passion about what's going on, about what you're feeling. What part of Texas are you in?
San Antonio.
Okay, my son is there. So we appreciate you for calling in, and I can hear your passion. We're going to take a quick break, y'all, while we kind of like meditate on what he was talking about, and we're going to come right back.
There are times I find it hard to sleep at night. We are living through such troubled times. And every child that reaches out for someone to hold, for one moment they become my own. And how can I pretend that I don't know what's going on when every second, every minute, another soul is gone? And I believe that in my life I will see, oh yeah, end into hopelessness or giving up. Thank you.
Beauty industry, then enroll in Beaver Beauty Academy. As a licensed beauty school, we offer training in cosmetology, nail technology, and aesthetics. We are the only cosmetology school in Metro Atlanta offering dual enrollment for high school students. Our 9-month intensive training, coupled with clinic floor services that's open to the public for hands-on experience, guarantees each student to pass their state bar exams and enter into the beauty industry as one of the best. So, if you're ready to kickstart your career, call us at 678-705-8058 or visit us online at beaverbeautyacademy.com.
New Birth Baptist Church, in collaboration with WorkSource DeKalb, presents the Citywide Career Expo on Friday, May 17th from 10 a.m. until 2 p.m. New Birth Baptist is located at 6400 Woodrow Road in Lithonia. For more information, call 770-696-9600 or visit www.newbirth.org.
Nah, you don't really know me, do you? I paid head off half you that's scared. I don't get my respect, I swear it's overdue. Hey. I still ain't where I wanna be, they thinking I done made it. I showed them none and took it, feeling like they obligated. I made a choice, if it's stressing me, I won't tolerate it. I got tired of waiting, I would think that you get tired of hating. This is more than a million viewers who think they love me but never met me. But more for those who can see me and them and won't forget me. Usually I'm alone, but at home I still got a family. This praying I win a Grammy, don't care if you understand me. That could be a blessing and a curse. You think I sound like her, she know I did it first. Don't tell me I'm too high, I'm charging what I'm worth. Niggas wanna eat, but they don't wanna work. I built this shit by myself, I don't need nobody help. Most niggas just wanna kick it, I might just give them a belt. You can't take this shit, cause it's in me. Who said I fell off, don't tell me. It's upset if you ain't with me. Can't break my heart, cause it's simply you. Again, you thought you could get me. Think I'm just somebody thirsty for another dollar, just so you could say I owe it to you. You when you wrong, soon as something going wrong, they be acting like they never knew you. Nah, you don't really know me, do you? I paid off half his debts, yet I don't get my respect, I swear it's overdue. You don't really know me, do you?
That is my jam. That is Dreezy.
Only thing.
That is Dreezy out of Chicago. I know you know her, right?
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. And Tink.
Yep, Tink.
I actually...
it's a lot of us out of the shot.
There's a lot of y'all.
We're in this city.
You know what? Chicago, in all fairness, got some of the best freaking talent ever. Because that's when I got into the whole artist thing in Chicago, when I lived in Chicago. And I started doing the indie events and stuff like that. The talent in Chicago is like no other. Like, I love, you know what I'm saying? If they, you know, stop, you know, being crabs in the barrel at each other and stuff and start supporting each other and helping each other, you know, we will see more artists out of Chicago that's actually more than just underground. You feel what I'm saying? The talent in Chicago
it's just the jits, man. It's a lot of the youngins that's acting a fool right now. You know what I mean? Like, you get support. Like, they support each other in Chicago, but it's just, you know, unfortunately, you know, when I grew up in Chicago, you know, we had a code. Everybody was respecting it, you know, the OGs. But now the youngins ain't respecting it. You know what I'm saying? They don't got no respect. You know what I mean? That's gone. You know what I mean? You say something to one of these jits now, they be ready to kill you. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, back in the day, they said something to me, I'm listening.
Yeah, yeah.
And then they going to take me home to my mama and be like, hey, you know, I had to bring him home. He was wilding.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But see, that ain't like that no more.
So, what's your name? Trap Fuego? Where are you from?
Smallest state on the map, actually, Providence, Rhode Island.
You from where?
Providence, Rhode Island.
Oh, for real? Rhode Island.
What makes that the bomb state?
Oh, I ain't been there in so long, so I wouldn't even know how to answer that. I was raised in Atlanta. That's just where I was born.
Oh, okay. So you've been here. So you're not a Grady baby then. You somewhere over there around the corner, and then you came back here.
Yeah. Something like that, yeah.
Okay. So I'm so bad with names. Jiggy, please.
There you go.
Trap.
No. She called me Jiggy.
Right.
That is not my name. It is Bigg Jigg.
Bigg Jigg, please say his name.
Trap Fuego.
Yes, Trap Fuego.
Trap Fuego.
I'm not, whenever it's time to say your name, just so
not Triggity Friggity. You know, everything is Wiggity Iggity with her.
You know what? I don't do that on purpose. I promise you I don't. And I'm really working on it. So that's why I always tell Marvin, I always have Marvin introduce the people most of the time, because I know I'm going to say something wrong. I need to just be spelling. He told me to use my phonics.
Word.
We got a caller on the line. What's up, Lil Rock?
What's happening?
What's happening? How you doing, sir? Where you calling from?
I'm maintaining. I'm calling from Long Beach, California.
Oh! California. Oh, California. What's going on?
I'm maintaining. Feeling good. You know what I'm saying? Sipping on this hot chocolate right now. You know what I mean? Hollering at my boy, Bigg Jigg.
What's up? What's up, Lil Rock? What it do, homie?
Man, I'm maintaining, man. Like the new music, man. Like what you're doing down there, man.
Hey, man, I appreciate it, man. Real talk, man. You know, we go back.
Oh, yeah.
Are you originally from California?
Nah, he from Arkansas.
Oh, okay.
From Little Rock. Yeah. That's why they call him Little Rock.
Yeah, I'm Little Rock.
Yeah, actor. Yeah, actor, not Cali.
You're doing big things. Do they need an actress? Because I can come out there.
Yeah, you gotta come out. Yeah, you gotta come so out. The, way out here.
What's the energy like out there since the whole Nipsey Hussle thing and whatever? What's the energy like in California right now?
It's way better now. You know, when it first happened, it was a little, you know, it was a little gloomy around the whole city. But now, you know, it's the energy. Then, you know, it didn't transpire. It got everybody, you know, leveling up on different levels. You know, black people, you know, we sticking together more, you know. You know, and everybody burning sage now all of a sudden, you know. But that's good.
Are they still having rumors about conspiracy theories and hits and all that kind of stuff? Y'all still hearing a lot of that?
Are they trying to take Marathon?
Yeah,
have you heard that, Lil Rock?
That is everybody. You know, everybody still, because, you know, he haven't went to court yet. So, yeah, everybody still hurt from it, but, you know, it's a lot of good coming out of it, too.
That's what's up. That's what we have to focus on. You know what I'm saying? We have to focus on what the blessing that he was able, you know, what he was able to do for his community, who he was, his message, and everything. And so I guess we have to look at that because there's nothing that we can do about the fact that he's gone. But I do feel like over time, the truth going to come out. So at some point, somehow, the truth is going to come out. You know what I mean?
It's going to come
out. And we're going to find out if Eric truly acted alone or not.
Yeah, personally, I don't think he acted alone, bro. I don't know. It just don't seem right.
You know what? In my opinion, when I seen it, you know, and this is just my opinion, but as soon as I seen it, I said that looked like a hit to me. Because I've been in the military, and to me, the whole thing just looked like a hit. But that's just my opinion, you know. But the truth is gonna come.
A lot of people feel the same way because that man should have never been touched, you know. He wasn't just know anybody, you know, and he'd been over there all the time, so why would they pick that day, right, and the next day he was going to go to the police station and try to unify the gang.
And then not only that, but where is the white car that was there that wasn't there afterwards, and why the way that he continued to come back, it was as if he was ordered to make sure that he was gone. You know what I'm saying? So that's just my opinion, and that's just how I look at it, and that just comes from me being in the military or whatever. But the truth's going to come out.
And then didn't nobody come out the store either. That was a little, you know.
Yeah.
You know.
And then the movement. When you watch the video, the movement of how everybody just starts moving away right before the guy comes. As if people knew it was just crazy to me. But that's just my own conspiracy theory, you know, and I may not be right, but the truth gonna come out. The truth is gonna eventually come out, and you know, the truth is gonna come out. But I'm glad the people are coming together, you know, the different gangs are coming together, the people are showing love to each other, and they're keeping his memory and what he stood for popping, you know. So that's the blessing.
Oh yeah, you know the marathon gonna continue continue forever through all of us.
That's right. What's your Instagram or your? Because I'm think you're an artist, right?
Yes.
Okay. What's your Instagram? How do we follow you? What's up?
It's LILROC2010.
Okay. Say it.
LIL.
No, I mean don't spell it. Say it.
Oh, Little Rock 2010.
Okay. All right, then. Well, thank you for calling in. We appreciate you, sir. What's your latest? You got a new hit or something out? What's your latest thing that we can look up on YouTube?
Oh, everything on there. I'm on the new Tupac, and I'm on episode 6 of the Tupac and Biggie Unsolved. You see me, I'm Tupac producer. He blow down. He come out there. I tell him to get out the booth. He come out and blow down on me.
Oh, wow. Okay. You an actor.
Yeah, actor.
Okay. Tell them there's a lady in Atlanta that says she can act. I can be somebody's mama.
You know, Atlanta doing big things down there too. Y'all coming up with the acting.
Yeah, we are. Yeah, we are.
They're coming up really big time out here.
Quick.
This is a Black Hollywood out there.
Right.
Yeah, I auditioned for a couple little shows out there. I'm waiting to hear back some. You know, they can slap me out there, do a little something.
Right. Okay. Well, thank you for calling in, sir. We appreciate you.
All right. Big G, keep doing your thing, homie.
Hey, appreciate it, homie. Real talk. You know it's love.
I want to touch on the topic that you was talking about earlier about the child abuse, because I think that Child Protective Services plays a major part in that. The question is, there's a lot of children out there that's being abused and neglected, and my whole theory about that is why is it Child Protective Services not doing anything about it when it comes to certain kids?
You know what? For one thing, I can see it on both sides of the plate. So for one thing, let's talk about our community. For me, when I became an adult, I went back to my old neighborhood. Uh-huh. And I lived in a half a double when I was growing up, right? So we lived in the back and the family lived in the front. And so they literally could hear my screams. The people could hear my scream. They knew I was being tortured. And I found this out because I ended up running into some people who lived in the neighborhood who said the people who lived in the front half a double told them. But never did those people knock on our door. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of times people know what's going on in the community and they won't say nothing, you know, or even people in the family, extended family. My stepmother's extended family had to know what was going on, but they never did nothing. You know what I'm saying?
But I still think it goes more than just a community, because I think you understand what I'm talking about.
No, I was going to get to that. I'm just saying it's two sides to it.
Yeah, it's two sides.
People don't always report. Yeah. That's for one. And then a lot of times when they do report and they do actually take them out the home, they end up sending them back. Why would you, if you got to pull the child out of the home because the child hasn't been fed, the child got broken extremities, bruises.
Is a check to them.
Huh?
That child is a check to them. I was also in the system, grew up in the system.
Right. And come over to the, say who you are and come over to the.
Hello, they call me Trouble.
They call you Trouble? Are you Trouble for real? Because I got some handcuffs. We got to lock her up. Go ahead and start some trouble then.
But what I was saying was, you know,
pull that mic to you.
The system isn't any better. You know, you send us to people that's just like the person that did that wrong to you. It's full of people like that. It's full of cops that molest children in a juvenile center. You know, you think that's the safe spot, and it's not. You know, so as soon as they not getting that check for that child, or that check running low, or that parent get involved, they let that child go. Or you go to the next foster care. You've been abusing that house. You've been abusing the home, because all you are to them are a check. Mm-hmm. So they can care less whether.
Let me see your hands. I can already tell just by your energy. I could tell that you went through some stuff. I could feel it. I can feel that you're still dealing with some stuff. I can just see it. And so the one thing I'm going to say to you, and the one thing I had to learn, in spite of what they did to you, you have to forgive. And sometimes it's easier said than done, because there was time I used to ask myself, what did I ever do? Why me, God? I had to learn to forgive him. So I always believe that things happen for a reason. I don't believe in accidents. I never believe that. So if the reason why you were here was because of you, I want you to know that God loves you. I want you to know that you do have a story to tell. There's going to be other people that you're going to be able to help. But before you can get to that point, you're going to have to forgive. Because the God cannot use you the way he needs to be able to use you until you do that. And it's hard. It is. It's hard. It's, God knows it is. But I can feel your energy. I can feel it. You may never forget, but please, for you and for everybody connected to you, you have to forgive. Your relationships will be affected if you don't. The way you deal with your children will be affected if you don't. Everything will be affected if you don't. For him to use you, the way that he's going to use you, because you're chosen. We were chosen. We didn't ask for this. We were chosen. And you were chosen because God knew you were strong enough to get through it. So what I ask you today, forgive them. Forgive them. Forgive them. Do you hear what I'm saying to you? This whole show today was for you. Do you hear what I'm saying? This whole show today. And I know you got a story to tell. Mm-hmm. You got a ministry inside of you. You got people you're going to help. You got people you're going to save. So please forgive them. Do you hear me? Do you hear me? Praise God. Let's take a break. Can we take a break?
New Birth Baptist Church, in collaboration with WorkSource DeKalb, presents the Citywide Career Expo on Friday, May 17th from 10 a.m. until 2 p.m. New Birth Baptist is located at 6400 Woodrow Road in Lithonia. For more information, call 770-696-9600 or visit www.newbirth.org.
Morris Brown College is a private, co-educational, historically black college located in Atlanta, Georgia. This school was founded in 1881 by the AME Church for the education of black people. Morris Brown College still stands today as the only historically black college founded in Georgia by black people. The school has officially begun its quest to earn its accreditation. Please consider giving to Morris Brown College by visiting the website morrisbrown.edu.
Look at you thinking you couldn't live without him, now look at you living. Look at you doing way better in all out of your feelings. Your head just came back and your booty is getting a little bigger. Girl, duck that little hitter. Girl, duck that little hitter. Cause you don't deserve that. Girl, you don't deserve that. Girl, you don't deserve that. And you can do better. You don't deserve that. Girl, you don't deserve that. Girl, you don't deserve that. Girl, you can do better. You fell in love with a dog hitter. Now you feel like you can't trust hitters. You the one that would've stuck with him. I know you knew he was a dog hitter. Why you let him do you like that? Why you let him do you like that? You leave once and be right back. Why you let him do you like that? You let him cheat on you. You let him beat on you. You scared to be single, huh? You need to leave, homie. He call you ugly names. Your mind ain't feeling the same. You going through bodily change. Girl, get back on your game. Friends try to tell you leave him, but you're feeling like you need him. He can cheat right in your face, and you still gonna believe him. Then a good man come along, and you push him away. You push him away. You gotta do better. Look at you thinking you couldn't live without him. Now look at you living. Look at you doing way better in all out of your feelings. Your head just came back, and your booty's getting a little bigger. Girl, duck that little hitter. Girl, duck that little hitter. Cause you don't deserve that. Girl, you don't deserve that. Girl, you don't deserve that. And you can do better. You don't deserve that. Girl, you don't deserve that. Girl, you don't deserve that. And you can do better. You deserve flowers on Tuesday. Not a single but the bouquet. I know you had a real long day. Let you pop open the deuce. Not on Netflix and chill. Baby, that ain't what it is. Need a real boss in your corner. Help you pay some of them bills. I see the stress on your shoulders. Girl, let me take it all. You let them know it'll hurt you. Now you won't rock with a ball. I see the pain in your eye. When I look at you, know you tried all these hitters. Baby, just hear me through. I got a PlayStation at home. I ain't finna play with you. Tell me what you want. Whatever you need, I do. I don't think you know your worth, baby. I can't sit back and watch you hurt, baby. Look at you thinking you couldn't live without him. Now look at you living. Look at you doing way better in all out of your feelings. Your head just came back and your booty's getting a little bigger. Girl, duck that little hitter. Girl, duck that little hitter. Cause you don't deserve that. Or you don't deserve that. Or you don't deserve that. And you can do better. You don't deserve that. Or you don't deserve that. Or you don't deserve that. And you can do better.
Yeah, that was emotional. Go. What did you say? What did you say during the break?
I was saying that the forgiving and letting go is the hardest part.
It is,
you know, mm-hmm. because we can say forgive all day long, but that memory, that feeling, never goes away. You know,
there's a part in the Bible where they asked Jesus, "How many times should I forgive somebody?" Right, and I believe he answers, and I'm not a Bible scholar, but I think he says something like 70 times 7. Because a lot of stuff is generational. Mm. You know what I'm saying? If you go to that abuser and you look at their life and their history, somewhere you're gonna find abuse.
Hurt people, hurt people.
Hurt people, hurt people.
But those hurt people that are hurt people are the ones that's running our world today.
And that's why you have to still tell your story, sweetheart.
You got to. We have to. If we don't stand up as survivors and say, listen, legislation has changed because people who have come through start banding together and doing stuff. When drunk drivers kept killing people, right? Mad, what was that? Mad
mm-hmm.
Mothers Against Drunk Driving came together, right? And they did make changes. They did what they could do. You do what you can do. We as together, we because of sin and Adam and Eve and all that kind of stuff, there's certain things we ain't gonna never be able to change. It's always gonna be. But we can do our best. We can do what our purpose is. While you didn't get killed, you didn't die, you ain't crazy, you're not in a mental place, you're not dead because God is still planning on using you because you were chosen. You understand what I'm saying? And because you're chosen, before he can use you the way he needs to, you got to let the healing process. Forgive him. Because you're going to have to tell somebody else the same thing. Because if there's people who, if they don't forgive, they're going to be dead because stress, because all the different things, because of whatever. But that person, that abuser, they own their life. They doing their whatever they doing. They may not even remember. So our job is to tell the people. I tell the people every day, all this that you see, the books, the movie, the radio station, all that kind of stuff, it's all because I'm on a mission. And the mission is to raise awareness. Now you figure out what your mission is. But in the process of finding out what your mission and your purpose is, you gotta forgive. I'm sorry, did the person hang up? I'm sorry, y'all. I'm sorry, y'all. It's a deep topic today, you know what I'm saying? And we love callers, and I promise y'all, I'm sorry we don't mean to have y'all hanging up. You know what? Somebody call back. Keela, I'm so sorry, Keela.
It's okay.
Where you calling from, Keela?
I'm from South Carolina.
South Carolina in the house. All around the world right now. So what's going on, Keela? What you want to talk about?
You know, really, I was just calling in to say what up. I don't know. I mean, I'm an artist.
Okay, what's your Instagram and your social media handles?
All my social media is Keela For Real. Mm-hmm. That's K-E-L-A, the number 4, and then real.
So what are your thoughts about what we were talking about?
Keela got a good song, too.
Oh, she do?
She got an excellent song.
What's the name of her song?
It's called Dreaming.
Oh, it's called Dreaming. It's on YouTube?
It's Yes, ma'am. It's everywhere.
Okay. And your name is spelled K-E-L-A?
For Real.
Yes, ma'am.
Number four.
K-E-L-A, the number four, Real, R-E-L.
Okay, that's what's up. So we're going to have to, and it's called Dreaming. It's nice, huh?
It's really a nice song. R&B song.
Oh, snap. You know, we don't have enough good singers. Some of y'all rappers, I don't even know what y'all be talking about. But so we need to promote more singers. That's what's up. So, okay. So what are your thoughts about what we've been talking about today? Do y'all experience any type of police brutality type stuff, domestic violence, whatever? What's the big thing in South Carolina?
I mean, of course, the biggest thing you see is racism, I think, more so down here. And sometimes the issue about all of this with me is so hard to decipher between the good cops and the bad cops. Because I feel bad for the cops that really are trying to do their job and just trying to make a difference. Mm. And you know, it's hard seeing my uncle is a cop. Mm. And you know, he sees a lot of backlash coming from, you know, the white cops. And I mean, you know, it's almost hurting to me because I got pulled over, I say, about a month ago. And, you know, I ain't gonna lie, I was nervous. I was in a little country town and a white cop pulled me over. I was by myself. And I'm thinking like, oh, Lord, let me get my registration and stuff out. And for some reason, I could not get my glove compartment open before he got to my car. Mm. So when I let the window down, I mean, he could tell that I was nervous. And I said, I'm not doing anything. I'm just trying to open my glove compartment. And, you know, he could tell that I was nervous. He was like, you know, he was like, it's okay. He was like, you just don't worry about it. Because, I mean, they don't care anymore if you're male, female, anything like that. So you always got to have your guard up.
Mm. Well, I appreciate you for calling in, SD.
Shout out to Keela.
We're going to check out your song, too, Dreaming.
Yeah, Dreaming.
Please do.
Sure will. Thank you. We got time for one more call. Is that Easy Rex?
Yeah.
What's going on, Easy Rex? I already know you're an artist because you got Easy Rex. So you got to be an artist.
Yeah, I'm an artist.
What's your Instagram? What's your Instagram?
My Instagram is easy_raxx.
Okay. You got any music coming out?
Yeah, I actually do got some music coming out, and I got some music that's released. I'm dropping an EP next month.
Okay. You got some on YouTube?
Yeah, I'm actually on YouTube, Spotify, Apple Music, Tidal, Deezer.
And name one of your songs.
Off-White.
Okay, we're going to check you out. Thank you for calling in.
Yep.
So, I want to give him a chance to...
Trap Fuego.
Fuego, come and tell your Instagram, social media handles before we... get ready. Our hour is almost up. Dang. Did that seem like that went fast?
Last hour.
You know what I'm saying?
Really fast.
Get right. And that's how it is every week. Like, it seems like it just speeds by.
That's why we be needing 2 hours on
us. Yeah. Right. After he tells his social media handles, tell them about your show that comes on, you know, or whatever. But so what's your social media?
Okay, well, you guys can follow me at Trap Fuego Everything. That is TrapFuego. And go check out Trap Season. The album has just dropped the 26th. Make sure to take a look.
Okay. And, you got something on YouTube?
I like that 1100, you know what I'm saying?
Huh?
1100.
Oh, you got 1100?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. 1100.
1100 blocks. Some keep it 100, some keep it 1,000. We're going to keep it 1100.
Okay. You was meant to come in today with 1100.
Yes, ma'am.
You meant to come on 1100. Okay, that's what's up. So what's your, thank you for coming in today. And thank you for bringing trouble.
No problem.
Trouble brought you. You didn't even cause no trouble. Actually, you probably caused some healing. Mm-hmm. So what's your show?
We got a show on Holly Unique Radio, the Dinner Club, every Saturday night from 10 to 12. I don't think we're going to make it this Saturday because we're going to be out of town Friday. I don't know if we'll make it back on time or not. But.
So there's a certain app that you, or a certain, where, how do they get,
yeah, they can to? They can download the app, Holly Unique Radio, you know, Google Play Store, or what's the other one? Apple.
Yeah.
Apple app, whatever that thing is called. But they can download the app from there.
Okay. Yeah. And don't forget to, for all of you who you listen to this week's show and you are still dealing with unforgiveness, getting Marvin's book, Building You, would be a good thing, you know. And then whatever other kind of healing type things that you can do, meditation, prayer, church, whatever it is that allows you to center yourself and spend time with the Most High. And then just release that unforgiveness so that God can use you, you know. You can't do anything about yesterday, but.
I actually did that myself.
You did?
Yeah, because I went through that abuse with my mother. My mother was very abusive. And not to mention that, you know, just being abused as a child and being sexually raped by my uncle at 5 years old. You know, growing up, you know, and being on drugs to try to mask that pain. It took a lot for me to get over that, and I had to just do that on my own. Mm. And that's because I realized I love me more than trying to kill myself.
Amen.
So yes. I had to forgive them. Not for them, but for me, because that was the only way for me to move on with my life. And it took a long time. A long time. Because at that time, nobody really knows what forgiveness really is.
Right.
Because you wasn't taught that. The only thing that you know was pain. So it took me years to get to where I am now. A long time.
Well, thank you for sharing your story. I want to thank y'all for listening. And you will be able to get through this. Just stand up, y'all. Until next week on the Move Unscripted.